Well, welcome back to Let's Play Silent Hill Downpour Blinds. Although, seeing as this is the second playthrough, is it really blind at this point? I mean, some elements, sure, but not much. It's more of me just trying to remember, you know, where to go and what to do, like in the first playthrough. Before we get up with that, let's go over here. Oh. Well, never mind then. Oh, here we go. You wanna go, douchebag? Oh god. Oh. Ow. I could have electrocuted you, but I chose to do this instead, because I want that trophy. I probably won't get it, because you really don't get enough opportunities to use guns in this game. What? I didn't say that. What button was it? Oh, you don't have a first aid kit. That's why it wasn't working. Wow, that's a bitch. Run! Ah. God damn it. Murphy's just too slow. Oh, where did it last autosave? Probably around the time that guy busted out, or before it. Wouldn't be so bad if the load times weren't so freaking slow. Gives you plenty of times for the games to give you useful hints, like staying calm when you cross a balance area, and to listen to what Murphy has to say at certain points in the game. Save ammo duties, sort of. I mean, it's still a waste of the bullet, but you know. Counting towards the trophy here. How the fuck do I dodge that? That's how we do it. Can't remember if there was anything. Well, I can just turn it off. Which, you know, go in that room in safety. Don't think there's really anything in here, but chair, toilet, bed. Quite the drop there. God, this freaking light source sucks, doesn't it? You know, I feel like if this was, you know, an earlier Silent Hill game, we'd have to, like, you know, turn that valve there, but now it's just there for, you know, purely for decoration. And examine it. So, alright, I got a pass. I'm allowed to be here. I know why the light occasionally turns off like that, but it's kind of annoying. Oh, now it is. Just have to play the security footage. Was it Outlast that had some kind of thing like that, or am I thinking of a different game? Either way it goes, it's a game I've not actually played. Now, funny thing about Outlast, right? One Christmas, you know, my sister's like, oh, what do you want for Christmas? It's like, nah, you know, this game, Outlast, why not? And I'm not sure if she actually bought it or not. She said she did, but she has no idea what happened to it. So either she didn't actually get it, or it just got lost somewhere. I have no idea. Never played the game. To be honest, considering it's basically a run like fuck for the entire game kind of game, not really the biggest fan of that type of game to begin with, to be fair. Like, the whole trial and error, run like fuck, die a million times, and then rinse repeat. Was there anything back there? I pressed the button, what did it do? I don't. Oh, it's probably for that other door. Was it the Evil Within? Never played that game. Maybe that's the one I was thinking of with security footage. I can't remember. I was seeing PewDiePie play the one video or two back in the day. And, you know, it doesn't look like the kind of game I'd enjoy. It looks frustrating as all hell. I can't remember if it was Silent Hill or Resident Evil. Like, someone that worked on either one of the series that, you know, made that game. I think it might have been the director of Silent Hill 1, I can't remember. That was Silent Hill or Resident Evil. Spooky, bizarre disappearances. So, no one here, right?
The guards can pass their sidearms through that window.
Can't even carry a light source.
Yeah. Finally.
Be like, oh, by the way, Murphy, it also picks up your clothes. You can't wear clothes when going past here. Gotta pick it all up individually. Just like that. That's all there is. Oh god, it's this room. Well, we're on easy mode this time, so that shouldn't be too much of a hassle. And these guys. I mean, if anything, I could probably rack up a lot of shotgun guineas. Still doubt I'll get that trophy. It's kind of ridiculous. This, you know, way of switching from weapon also sucks too. It's reloading, asshole. Oh my god. I get Murphy's not a... What the fuck is this? Have I already run out of ammo? Oh god. A fucking shotgun, for god's sake. Right to the face. And all the time it feels like it does nothing. Shot, dick. Cause he's a dick. Shot to the chest. Cause... I don't know. Oh, gun control, we got the trophy. Yay! Now I can go back to just... whatever, I guess. Soon we read this, he'll be gone. His name Ricky or something like that, right? And the... where is it? Yeah, the implication there. Is there anybody out there? I guess they expect you to run around here, you know, to dodge and shit. Isn't there something in here? I don't need this. Just an alternate option in case we lose our current weapon. That's our primary destination. We gotta get this code. Good thing I still got the axe. First playthrough, I was being chased the whole goddamn time. Because I kept triggering the alarm. All that's in here is a freaking first aid kit. Speaking of which, we got all those first aid kits. Some of them were rewards for side quests. Those not even cross over to this section. It's like, what's the bloody point in doing these side quests if even though the rewards are mediocre, you don't even get to keep them when you advance the plot. It's like, what was the point? It's bullshit. Okay, so we gotta avoid setting off stupid machinery. So let's move this out of the way in advance, because it's gonna be a code. You can let go now, Murphy. It's like, it tricks you. You feel like you gotta interact with all that machinery, right? No, you don't turn that on. You gotta keep that shit turned off. It alerts the assholes. Wait, what? Was this before or after he took his life, presumably? And what does he mean, together again? Because it sounds like his significant other was alive. I think the first... Well, I don't know, actually, because, you know, the combat may be set to easy mode this time, but puzzle difficulty is set to
hard. What have we here?
So it could be a little different. That's two. Thing is, I don't remember what order it goes in. Just gotta follow footsteps. It's 2-2. Murphy, this might be good for you. What do you think? You'd be like, I don't remember my address or anything, so I don't know how I can fill out this form.
You never stopped trying to help me, did you, Frank?
Hell, I don't even know what city I'm in. There we go. Not sure. Yeah, 2-2-3. I think it's the same as last time. Any moment is gonna come around that corner. What's this? It's part of machinery too. Yeah. Or maybe some difference. Wait, I think there might be. No. Where's it? Does it lead? Two, three, five. I'm not sure if I'm missing a number. Actually, I think I am. Is there a number on there? No? Alright, for fuck's sake. How did it even switch on? 2-2-3. I feel like there's a number missing. That'll be right. Bloody hell. Wait, what machinery's turned on? Not that one. And it's powered off. Well, because it's alerted the cavalry. I am certain there's another number somewhere. I'll try 2-2-3-5, but I don't think that's it. Yeah, there's a number missing. Like it was on a wall. And, you know, not this wall. I mean an outlaw. Let's retrace our steps. So we got two there. Come down here. And see an owl and there, so that's 2-2. That's a lot of machinery. I feel like there might have been another one that was on the ceiling, I don't know. Just think about it, you know? It's like 2-2-3, and then we come in here and there's 5. It doesn't make sense, does it? You'd think there'd be another number in here, and that's because there probably is. I just can't freaking see what it is. The lighting is just so bad in this game. I don't know where to bloody look. Let's retrace our steps a little. Kind of like, it makes it obvious there's a number up there. Was that around here? And thing is, it doesn't actually stop. The trail just keeps going. Like, maybe a little gap in between. That's about it. Maybe that's the tickets. Shut up! For a little gap. Somewhere here, I guess. I'm not seeing another number anywhere though. Not on the floor, it's not on the ceiling, it's not on the fucking table. Like another gap somewhere? Not making it clear, game. I mean, sure, there's numbers here, but they're not painted.
Hmm.
Those people who have probably played this game on YouTube, you know, would have already found this freaking number by now, but me? I don't know if I'm just blind or what, but I just can't freaking see where this freaking number is supposed to be. Because the pattern looks like a gap. That's a gap. That's a shut your trap. Like just the slightly subtle little gaps in footsteps highlighting spots here. Maybe it's in the doorway. No. There's nobody coming or what? Distractions. Who knows, maybe they'll lead me to the right way. I thought I saw something, but I guess not. Okay. No. Where the flippity fucky boo-da-ba is this stupid last number? I don't think it's actually the last number, it's the number in between the last number. It's like, that makes it obvious, you know, big number. But I don't see anything else. It's like, this stupid hammer over here keeps highlighting. And it's annoying me, so I'm going to throw it away. And then reveals underneath it was the number all along. No. I mean, seriously? This is just pure insanity at this point. I'm just looping. At this point, I could have just freaking guessed the code. Just fucking hell. I don't find it anywhere. Unless maybe it doesn't exist, and that's the whole point. It's like you gotta figure out the number in between, but why would they do that? If you see the gap, it's kind of implying to be somewhere over here, but it doesn't really give you a sense of direction. You know what, actually? Move it around. Maybe that's what I'm doing wrong here. Get a bit of movement. A bit of freedom, Murphy. That's what you want. Oh, for God's sake. Shut it. But this is the gap. I'm still not seeing crap. Like, look at this freaking 5, it really stands out. Whatever number's in between certainly doesn't. That's the only thing you can really move. And they have some nerve throwing a literal wrench here. Made me think, oh, that's the one. No, it isn't. Wait, didn't I pick that up? What the fuck? Did you respawn or something? This fucking machinery is thick. I'm about ready to give up on finding this fucking thing and just freaking guessing the number. Seriously, no one's showing up. Look at guesswork, here we come. 2, 3, 1. Ah. 2, 3, 2. Ah. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a 4 somewhere in between. Let's look for a 4. Well, that doesn't really fucking matter because I can't see shit in here. But there's a number in between. I know that much. I just don't know where the fuck it is. And it bothers me that I don't know where it is. Unless it just doesn't actually exist and you are in fact supposed to get that one number for some reason. Because the developer's like, fuck you. You might as well be a dog chasing your own tail right now. Alternatively, the game could be, you know, glitched. That could be another explanation. Because I ain't seeing no number, unless, maybe, no, or maybe like one of these would be highlighted in white, but it doesn't look like it. That turns out to actually be in this little box that you can't highlight it. Oh, fuck it, I can't be arsed. I'm gonna lose the number anymore. Oh, which one went off? Oh, fuck it, I don't even care. You just spawned out of nowhere, sir. Now we've already got a quarter, so we've got a spare here. Like, I picked that up as the dust was playing. Come fast, Murphy! Because I didn't know how to play this section. Hell, it slows you down for that. What's the point in the second quarter, though? Crawl! And fall. And imagine if he landed on that. That'd be a painful but quick death. Look how this shit starts. This is the most ridiculous fight. Look at this. He just pulls him down. He's like, "Hey, gonna smack you." Also, it looks like punches you see in wrestling where it's not even connecting. That's one thing I noticed about modern wrestling, you know? A lot of wrestlers can do all kinds of acrobatic shit, but they can't throw a punch with shit. I guess he thought he was Rocky. He's like, "I didn't hear no bell." Oh god. You can come around here? Pulling that shit? I think not. That's for you, sir. Don't bother getting up. And you too. I think we need another card, right? Wait, what? He's still alive? That dude would have definitely got up if I didn't do that. Aw, oh, man, I could have done something funny. I could have been like, you know, "Have a drink, get drunk." Just throw it at him. That's just the benefit of playing on easy mode here, you know? Don't have to worry about getting game overs constantly. So you can just goof around in the combat a bit. I am not looking forward to the, you know, third playthrough because I'm on hard mode. There's gonna be many a game over, and I'm pretty much gonna off-screen most of that playthrough. It's like I'd probably on-screen the bits where, you know, I'm picking up the past pieces stuff to get the secret ending. Maybe some of the fail in between as well. Is there nothing else you? Access card on both sides, or just the one. Excuse innocent man. I wonder how many innocent people have been executed throughout history. Probably quite a lot. Yeah, this was Frank looking into Sewell, because Sewell is a corrupt bastard. And that's why Sewell, you know, did what he did. Tell me, Lord, what did I ever do that was worth loving you for the kindness you've shown? So what is the song choices in this game? What even genre would this be called? We don't need no instruments except an acoustic guitar. That's why it feels like this music is. All we need is a guitar and some singing. I guess maybe it'd be folk, I don't know. Is it folk or folk? Folk probably isn't it that pronounced. Folk music. I can't play acoustic guitar very well, to be honest. I've got an electroacoustic and I just can never get used to the way the strings feel to hold down. It's much easier to hold down strings on an electric guitar. I know, maybe, you know, some acoustic guitars are just, you know, better. Got better feel to it, but the one I've got, you know, every acoustic guitar I've played basically is, you know, hard to hold down. So I can, you know, play bar chords and stuff, but it feels awkward to get the notes to ring out when doing that. Whereas being more an electric guitarist. And the funny thing is, I don't even play it when it's plugged in, most of the time. I just pick up my guitar, not plugged in, you know, it doesn't need all the volume and all that, I just jam along with my guitar. As such, in fact, actually. You know, that song where it's like... It's like E minor add 9. I think that was probably one of the song's tracks that has drawn me to playing add 9 chords, because they have quite a nice sound. It's like a lot of the songs I've wrote over the years but never actually recorded. Because, you know, when it comes to songs that I recorded, well, wrote, it's like, well, how would I go about recording those songs? Because, like, it's got the chord progression and lyrics, but, you know, that's about it, usually. Maybe a guitar solo there, but, you know, it's got to have the bass and drums on it, don't know how to approach it. But either way it goes, I'm quite fond of using the E minor add 9. Could even add in the minor 7 to make it just an E minor 9. Which is weird, you got E minor add 9, but if you add in a 7, it's just an E minor 9. It's not no longer add 9, it's 9. Hell, I even play it in a variant with a very odd sounding chord, an E minor major 7. So, what would that actually be called if you add a 9 to that chord anyway? This is how it sounds. It's basically an E minor chord, but you're adding a major 7, which gives it a bit of a dissonant sound, and then I like to add the 9. You know, I'm gonna extend this part here, though. So, you know, I'm actually gonna do what I currently do with my Lil Buster Let's Play, where it's like I do one long recording, and then, you know, partway through, I'm like, okay, see you next time, viewers, see you next time. Split it up, usually. I mean, I do that anyway with this Let's Play. I've done it a few times. I don't even, you know, point that out. I just keep recording for, like, a little over an hour and then split into two parts. That being said, whatever. Yeah, I'll say it here and that'll be the, you know, part. This part ends here, part 40, whatever. And the next part continues on immediately after, but, you know, upload wise, that'd be 4 days later. So, yeah, we'll do it like that. So, see you next time, viewers. See you next time.